I try to think I'm a unique person, okay? I think I'm pretty unique. I think what I do in Notion is pretty unique. But the problem is, I don't know what the heck I'm doing half the time. Like, I make these videos and I'm like, what do I make them about? Oh, wait, I do a lot of quirky stuff that people probably don't know. Like, for example, I color code everything in Notion. I got four main trees in my life. Rise productive, growth for getting jacked, life, self-explanatory, and work. And in those four categories, they're all color-coded. You might be saying, Dimitri, why the heck would you color-code the pages? Like, who would color-code a page? Well, listen here, son. When you do the Notion search feature, guess what? Does it help a little bit to find different pages based on their color when I look at this? Watch this. If I copy this, put it in here. Interesting. And I do only search titles. Now you see it, don't you? Then you get a little color-code action. You can see everything. If I go text stack, I'm going to get the exact page I need. People go, oh, the Notion search function sucks. I'm like, color code, duh. All you gotta do in order to make this happen is in this anywhere, just put this, type yellow, red, whatever. Just put an emoji color every time. And then once you have the base main page, like this Rise Productive or Growth, you then just can easily copy it on any new page that you make. And I even go further and have them in their own resource and roots databases. And I just can easily color code them in batches like this. But why wouldn't you just color code the pages? And then if they don't have a color, then they're like the master one. Or you can make a master color. I don't know. I probably actually should do that. That's a good idea. And then another thing a lot of people don't do is they have all their databases like out in the open, just ready to get accidentally deleted. If I delete this, nothing actually happens, right? I can go back into the journal and fix it. I don't want to do that because I'm just lazy. But the real thing is actually housed on the page somewhere. And where is this housed, you might ask? In resources. And where is resources housed, you might ask? The earth, which is the back end where I have all of my functional databases and alignment databases. All my tasks, events, projects, resources, alignment is in the back end. Because then I can easily copy out the views from here and paste them onto pages like this. And then if I delete this for some reason, it's fine. It'll be totally fine. I could just take it from the back end and paste it in there. Also, what you didn't know about that situation is the fact that if you do utilize this earth principle, when you have these views, right, the only views that come up as ones that you're able to use based off the databases come from the actual databases themselves. So this linked preview is not something that I can actually just take and make. If I do slash table view and I use the tasks and events, what you'll notice is the only options that I got were from the different ones that were here. So what you do is in the back end, you make views that you want to make sure that you never lose or that you want to replicate on other pages. And then when you make a linked view, you'll have the choice to rip them and put them into linked views. And another thing, use sync blocks more. I have a two-pronged sync block approach to have all of my life organization. Like I got this bad boy on the right here, which organizes, it's kind of my main heavy hitters. Like, got my meal planning, my workouts, my habits here. And then I got the main heavy hitters of like the resources and stuff. Like if I wanted to, based on how this is, I could obviously take this and replace it with the earth page for if I wanted to do that so that I can go and edit the back end stuff here or even a third one here. But this sync block here shows me across all these different pages that are appropriate. Hey, what is the current posting month and what month am I creating content for? While also having these guys right here easily accessible for views that matter, and then specific pages right here. It's like literally all the heavy hitters that need to exist in multiple different ways. Well, also, a really cool book library that I have a free template on is filtering everything based on this synced header view. It's now reading, but this one is filtered for up next. And it has the exact same view, but it just basically changes filters based on the page that's in it. Use sync blocks more, color code, use the earth. And check out this video on how to improve your productivity and Notion skills even more.